I should say I read an article very recently by a US academic, essentially saying that all academics overestimate the number of hours that actually work each week. And because you keep hearing another academic saying they're working 70 or 80 hours a week, you feel under pressure that you're not working 70 or 80 hours a week, so you start to say you're working 70 or 80 hours a week, and it's sort of additive. Now, that said, I work 80 hours a week. No. But you do have to put the hours in, I think. But I feel it is possible to have that balance, but you have to be very, very careful with how you arrange the, you know, the work that you're actually doing. There might be specific times where you shut off. Now, I have a particular rule that I usually stick to, is that when I get up in the morning, I don't look at my phone until I come into the office at about 8 o'clock in the morning. I figure that if I see an email at 10 to 7, I probably won't have time to actually answer it. I actually quite enjoy my commute into work. I listen to podcasts. If I've got that email in the back of my mind, it ruins it. So that starts off the day well for me. So that's a sort of one little trick that I do. And it's sort of trying to make the best use of your time, whether it's, you know, you've always got your iPad with you, so you're able to keep on top of your emails. Or maybe you take that time to say, turn off the email, so you can focus on a particular task, whether it's writing a paper or getting that grant application in. I don't think I'm that good at it myself. You know, whether other people feel they're better at prioritising their time, I don't know.
Okay, thank you.